everyone. My name is Martin Lezic, and I'm part of this group of people who are doing the Fizzbox project. Thank you. My role is to use the energy modeling tools, building performance modeling tools, in order to evaluate evaluate different design features and approaches, and to see what would be the best approach from the energy point. Probably later we can analyze the comfort conditions as well. So briefly, my presentation doesn't contain too much words. It's slides and graphs, and I will skip all those things which we will discuss before. So basically just to point out the most important parts. This is how the model looks. It includes the zoning, thermal zoning of existing model. Plus on the left side, you can see the shading part of the proposed design. I think the first part of the analysis which should be done is to first to think in which climate you're putting your house. And this is the graphical presentation of the temperature flow during the 24 hours. Each line represents one day. Basically, what is interesting here, and this could be an idea also for the people who are standing behind this idea of this project, is that basically the temperature flow in November in Dubai are very similar to maybe temperature flow of the temperature in Belgrade during some hot day. I'm not speaking about extremely hot day, but a normal hot day. So basically, I think, except humidity, we'll see this later, but from the point of view of temperature, it's very similar condition to hot day in Belgrade. So basically, this design can be implemented as well as in Serbia tomorrow. Regarding a dew point, we have there maybe some issues. We will see this, which can generate the problems if we use some energy storage storage models. Also, the humidity is a little bit tricky. During the night, it goes up to 100%, but certainly above 80% all the time. So basically, this should be taken care of when heat recovery is analyzed, and as well as energy storage. And yeah, okay, this is, I'll just flip to this and maybe come to the some interesting slide. So basically, what I wanted to show with this slide is to emphasize actually the simulation results and the importance of the different impacts the climate is doing on this proposed design. So if we look first on the green line, this is the energy consumption for 1 week simulation, considering that there is no solar radiation at all. This is some theoretical case, but simply to see the importance of the solar radiation itself. The blue line above is when we turn on solar radiation. Then we are going to the red one, which is actually when we implement the shading. So basically, this is interesting thing, simply to see the impact of the shading on the energy consumption of the building. You will see later that I think there is still space for some additional optimization. This will be the next part of this analysis, actually, to if time and resources allows us to optimize the later the shape of the louvers in order to be sure that we are maximally protecting the shading, maximizing the shading of the space, because the solar shading is doing the most of the thermal load. What I wanted, and the topic of this presentation was, is actually some non-characteristic situation in which we are while modeling this building. So basically, usually when you are employing the building performance modeling tools, you are you are having task to predict the energy consumption for typical conditions. This means that you need to run the simulation for the whole year, but also considering that there is some preconditioning before, so that when you start the simulation from the 1st of the September, you already have some steady state condition. In this case, actually, the situation is completely different. You don't have any historical energy stored in the building. Actually, you're bringing parts from the Belgrade, assembling there, and then you start to run your model. So basically, your model is not conditioned, and then you start to condition it and immediately to see results. And this will bring some atypical behavior of the energy consumptions. So what we did in the next slides is simply I was analyzing. First, this is a graph for heating, but because we are short with time, I will skip heating because it's not so important. And I will just go to the cooling, is how the building will behave completely differently if we do the typical energy modeling or if we do the modeling with the break. So basically, what you see with the black line, I believe, is the case when the building was not conditioned until 1st of November, and then it was conditioned, and here are results for the 1st November only. And below are the results of the energy modeling considering that it was conditioned all the time. So basically you can see that what will happen in the case of this specific project when you built it there is that you will have the first day significant load just from the accumulated heat which is within the building elements, and this needs to be addressed and dealt properly. The simulation is done for the case of very lightweight construction. This effect would be even much higher if there is a heavyweight construction, so this should be addressed as well. The next thing, this is just an illustration. We didn't do this analysis, but this is the analysis which is typically done for the residential building when you have a ground content. In this case, we don't have it. So the building is elevated, so basically below are the conditions which are similar to the outside conditions. But in the case that it's not, so basically again, this is one typical thing which is which is characteristic for this project, but not for the others. Also shortly about the influence of orientation and on the shading as well. This was just a small play. We rotated model and we evaluated how much it will influence on the energy consumption. And interesting is just by rotating the building, we have about influence of 6% of the cooling energy consumption, which is significant in my opinion, considering that you're not touching anything else. And let's say we are coming close to maybe the next phase, and this is what will happen in I believe in January. And this is with the red line, you have the total cooling load presented. We switch to one day only, and below are the all contributors which are, let's say, summing up to the red line. The blue just below the red one is the influence of the solar, and I think this is the most dominant driver for the cooling energy consumption, plus the internal gains which are happening between the people presence and the equipment in use. So basically this needs to be analyzed properly, and the final technical solution should address these two parameters with care. Also this is something what I wanted also to show, that there is direct correspondence between the load and of course solar radiation. So here you will see the cooling load plus the external solar radiation and the outside temperature, and it's really obvious that that without more detailed shading, we will not reduce the cooling load significantly. Here is something, but I think it's not working because there is no code installed to run this this animation. But basically, the building performance modeling tool we are using is able to analyze the shading impact and to later to take it into consideration of energy consumption. What we discovered is that, for example, the middle glazed part on the south side, I believe, has still significant portion of the direct sun sunlight, and this is especially true in the later afternoon hours. So basically, what would be our recommendation is to think about the angles of the shading on the south part and to reoptimize it further. So yeah, that's it. The results are just temporary. It will fine-tune as the project is fine-tuned, and if anybody has a question, you can find us over here in the next 15 minutes. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.